Good day, mates. Greetings. Gosh, how's it going over there? I'm trying to be Australian with this intro. It's not working out really well. I have with me the man of the week every week, Eric Bailey, otherwise known as Legend PVM.
As Legend PVM.
How you doing today, mate?
Chapper.
Chapper? What the frick? That's not a word. That's not a word in any language ever. That sounds more British, though, if it was to be a word.
Yeah.
The heck, Chapper? That's great. Oh, my gosh. I am one of your hosts. Normally, I go me and then Eric, but my Australian thing threw off my entire life. So, gosh. I am TBCX, but you can call me Teddy. And then, you know, Eric's over
there. Eric.
So, yeah.
Thing.
Done with the Australian thing. Never going to do that again. So, that's a lie. I'm going to do it probably next time we talk. That's how it goes. So, we're going... This is the Gamer Jits Duo podcast number 15, and I know I just slammed the camera. Oh, snap. It's an earthquake! Okay. This is the Gamer Jits Duo podcast number 15. My eyes are, like, really wide today. I'm like, 15. Sorry. We're an entertainment podcast. We talk about things other than just going on delirious mental breakdowns. We talk about video games, mainly PlayStation, Destiny, Arrow, The Flash, superheroes, The 100, what The Walking Dead. That's about it. Comics sometimes. That's it. So yeah. Normally we start off talking about TV. And the shows that we watched last week first. But it takes... Yeah, we sort of go off on a tangent and it takes like up half the show. And we actually have a lot of stuff we can talk about today. So we're going to go through the news first. And then come back and at the end talk about TV. Because honestly, there's not much to talk about other than The Walking Dead and The 100. So
yeah,
it's fine to save it until the end.
I should say... I meant to say chipper.
Chipper. There we go. That's definitely
which means lively.
That's definitely British,
and
so.
There you go.
You probably got Chappy on your brain because of all the ads everywhere.
Yeah.
That looks, by the way, doesn't that look bad?
What?
Chappy. Just from the trailers.
It's weird. I just don't like the name.
Yeah, but, like, it's like, there's one robot to save us from all the other robots. Like,
you're our last hope, dude.
Haven't we done this a billion times already? Right. I don't know. That's just from the trailer, though.
I don't know. It feels like it's a little weird.
Yeah, it doesn't look good. But, then again, maybe it could be good. I didn't think Kingsman looked good either from the trailers. I thought that looked stupid, but I've heard it looks great.
Everything.
I've heard it is great, not looks great. But, but I do think we should start off with what we have been playing throughout the past week, because that doesn't take long at all. I still need to get that light bulb fixed. That light bulb is really bothering me. Just that it's not, like, I don't know. I'm used to having two rays of sun, one on my left and one on my right. They're really bright. But, like, if you're down here, like, look at this thing. Look at it! You're looking at a sun. Oh my! Oh, Destiny! Look at that.
Yeah.
So
speaking of Destiny.
Speaking of Destiny, and then we immediately go and scroll through our topics until we find a Destiny topic. And no, I'm just kidding. I don't even have one. We could talk about the update. They do a weekly update every week. Oh no!
The update
was
about updates.
we'll continue with that after we say what we've been playing. We forgot to do that, or we started to move on. Eric, what have you been playing? I have a giant list.
Well, I haven't been playing anything because, I mean, Destiny's taking up a lot of our time with raids. We were very efficient this week with raiding. We still
we only did it like two nights though.
Yeah, we have still have like two vaults left, I think.
Yeah.
But we did all of our Crotas in one day. I was, like, really surprised.
Yeah, that
I
was... It was good.
The Crux and the Word of Crota, so I have everything now. I'm happy. Yeah, well. GG, Crota. Never playing you again.
I got Abyss, so I'll take it. I was waiting for Abyss. Got that on, like, the second one, I think.
Oh, my gosh. When you say Abyss, I was thinking Light of the Abyss.
No, I still need that. Abyss Defiant.
Wait, you call Light of the Abyss Light?
No, just Light of the Abyss. I've never shortened it. And if I have shortened it, I probably just called it. I don't know. I don't think I've ever shortened it. But you know you've been playing other things. You know you've been on that Persona 4 for the rest of your life.
I haven't been able to play it that much this week. I've been stuck. When you play Persona and you finally get a new you know that point in time during between bosses where it's like, okay, you need to start training your people.
Yeah.
I'm in that stage, so I'm constantly going into the TV every day. Yes. And so it's I've been stuck there for a few days because I've had
that takes and stuff. Yeah, that takes a lot longer. Like, you can blow through in 2 hours, you can blow through a month if you're just doing social link stuff. Right. But if you have to go into the TV,
I just finished my school year, by the way, so it's becoming summer. Nice.
But if you have to go into the TV, you'll go into the TV, and then that alone will take up 2 hours. So that alone is a day. So
along with having college, I've been stuck on one day for the past 3 days.
Yeah, it's just how it is when you go into the TV. It's just how the time works.
But I can last in there a lot. So.
Yeah, I've tried to do. I was leveled properly for. Actually, I was over leveled on all of my characters I was over leveled for the boss, the most recent one, and then. Because of that, I was overleveled for the optional boss, too. The optional boss was 57. No, all my guys were 58. My guy's 60. Dude. My main character's 60. But I still haven't been playing it much. But Persona 4 and Destiny. You also have been doing daily bounties. I haven't been doing dailies in forever.
I haven't done dailies. I haven't done anything since I got in Saint 14. I've been... Yesterday, I went to a family gathering and had a bunch of fish and chicken.
I like fish and chicken. I like chicken.
Look, this isn't just fish and chicken. This is deep fried in oil, homemade stuff, dude. Mm. This is great stuff. Chickens. And caught by us.
You caught the chickens? You went out there and you chased them down?
But the fish was caught by us.
Nice. That sounds like a
really good
thing to do right there.
And later that night, I went bowling from 10 to 1 a.m.
Dang, dude. When was that? Friday or Saturday?
Yeah, last night.
Oh, dang. So.
I had a busy day yesterday.
You probably
I haven't had time to get my Saint 14 leveled up.
Yeah, I haven't leveled anything. It's not that I don't want to. It's that I kind of don't want to. that's
funny. Well, I wanted Saint 14 to be ready by Tuesday.
Yeah, that'd be nice. I don't know.
We could do it tomorrow. Tuesday I'm going to see if I can get a job, so.
Oh, well, that's...
Life,
that's
dude. Good. Life.
I've been playing a significant more than that. Significant amount.
Yes.
More things than that.
You have 60 hours in Persona.
Dude, I bought so many games. I don't have 60. I have 57 at the moment.
Hey, that was close enough.
But I have 57. But I haven't been playing tons of Persona, but since Persona is a portable game, I can take it places. Yeah. Persona's literally while I'm playing Destiny and waiting for people to join my fire team, I'll play Persona and stuff like that. So Persona's the game that I play within other games. It's pretty meta. And then the PlayStation Plus March lineup was announced and came out on Tuesday. They announced it an hour after they were live. That's what was weird. They fully posted the blog post an hour after they were all free.
Only downloaded thing.
We'll get to it. It's on on the topics. But yeah, that came out. So on Tuesday, we might as well talk about it now because I'm gonna say that I played all of them. So on Tuesday, I downloaded all of them, or Tuesday morning, I set all of them to download. And then afternoon, I went and I played there are four games for PS4 that are free this month.
Yeah.
So. I started off. Let me take a look at this article to remind myself. I started off with. I think I started off with Ali Ali 2. Yeah, Ali Ali 2 is really good. That's one of the better ones. Yeah. And then I I played each of these for like 45 minutes and just to like get a feel from each one. And then I played Oddworld New and Tasty, which is a very interesting game. It's not bad. It's just, I don't know. It's like a puzzle platformer that like controls oddly to me, and I'm like, eh, I just don't have the time. I'd rather spend the time doing other stuff. But it's not a bad game. And then Counter Spy is really good. That's also for PS4. That's PS4, Vita, and PS3, and crossplay between all three. That's that's freaking good. Yeah, Counter Spy is a lot of fun. Play that. Play Ali Ali 2. Has an insane soundtrack. It's really, really cool.
As good as Persona 4's soundtrack.
Probably not. Nothing's as good as Persona 4's soundtrack. And then Valiant Hearts The Great War is also for PS4, which I am going to play eventually.
Yeah. Maybe.
Probably.
Have you played any of the PS3 titles?
Popo and Yo is a PS3 title. I don't fully know what that's about. Sherlock, it looks interesting. Crimes and
Punishments.
Yeah. And then there's Sherlock Holmes Crimes and Punishment. Apparently the Sherlock Holmes game isn't that bad. But it's like, I don't know. I got so many games on PS4. But yeah, that's the PlayStation Plus March lineup. Go download them. Go play them. Play Counter Spy. It's freaking really good.
Counter Spy is the one that has piqued my interest the most.
Counter Spy is really good. It's fun. Yeah, Valiant Hearts is apparently a really good story, but it's very much a point-and-click adventure game. People don't stress that, but it is. It is a point-and-click adventure game. Like, you have to go, there's a guy in this building. You gotta go get his dog by going over and clicking on this door, but you can't open the door, so you gotta go find the key, and then you gotta mess with the rubble to find the key, and then get the key, and then get the door, and then get the dog, and then get to the guy, and then he'll help you. It's like, it's very much an adventure game.
You have to get this guy wine or something.
Yeah, I very much wasn't expecting how much of an adventure game it is. It's not bad, that's not my thing. I mean, it's not my thing. It's just very low on my list of things. Yeah.
Very specific here.
Yeah. But I'll sit down and play that. Ali Ali 2 is also really good. You need to give that a shot. That game's really fun.
Yeah.
And it's very short. Like, you could play that for like 30 minutes and be satisfied in like the fun department.
Yeah.
What else have I been playing? I played Oddworld a little bit, Ali Ali 2 a little bit, Counter Spy, Destiny for the Rays, Persona 4, and then there's one I'm saving for last, but I know there was one before that. I don't know. But on Saturday, or Friday, oh, The Order. I also played The Order, and I beat it. The Order 1886, the PS4 exclusive, which we are going to talk about next week, because Eric's going to rent it, probably, and he's going to play it, and then we can both talk about it. Because it was bad. I mean, it was pretty good. That's my explanation of it.
I heard the boss fight was underwhelming.
I kind of didn't mind it. I kind of sort of liked it.
You
can hear how everything I say about this game is, it was kind of sort of good. That's how I feel about this game in general, about everything about it. But we'll talk about it in detail when you've played it, because the story is really good. They have something with that story. They do. That'll be good for years to come, to be honest. I think that has a lot of potential. So I played that. We'll talk about that more next week. And then on Friday as well, I rented it, The Order, on Friday, and I played through that and beat it on Saturday. But on Friday, I bought a couple of games. Well, first I bought the Transistor theme on PS4, which looks awesome. And then I bought Lego Batman 3 Beyond Gotham in the season pass.
Nice.
And I may have pre-ordered Bloodborne. So looking forward to that.
I need to do that.
Yeah, all right. I just, honestly, if I didn't pre-order it, I would not have bought it. If that game came out and everyone was like, this is really challenging, it's like the Souls games, I would have been like, nah, I'm not going to buy it. But like, since I bought it, I know I'm going to play it, and I'll probably enjoy it
Here's the thing, dude. Like, the Souls games they were like, for me at least, the mechanics are easy to get down after like an hour of gameplay, and you're like, oh, okay, this is really simple.
Yeah, but
it's just timing.
Yeah, I get it. I'm just saying, like, the Souls games normally, that turns me off to.
Also, it's a different gameplay. In Souls games, you have sword and shield while.
I know. I'm just saying, like, the reviews are. Everyone says it's as difficult as the Souls game. And when it comes out and the reviews are all out and everyone's like, oh man, it's super difficult and all this, I would have, if I didn't have it pre-ordered, I would have been like, nah, just gonna keep playing whatever I'm playing. But since it's pre-ordered now, I'm gonna play it. And I mean, I'm not gonna, there's no way I'm gonna hate it, but like, I don't know. Now I'm definitely gonna play it and give it a real shot.
It's gonna be like Persona, so to say. Sort of, you're gonna have to like, think of your actions. Only it's gonna be live action, of course.
Yeah, I mean, it's not gonna be turn-based. I'm down with it. I just wouldn't have got it before, but
I can see that.
But
yeah.
Now, I'm definitely gonna give it a shot.
And since you've gotten it, I have more reason to get, so we can compare notes.
Yeah.
Dude, when me and Gabby were like on Skype just playing Souls together, like she was playing Souls on her computer, I was playing it on my Xbox. And we're just talking about it.
Yeah.
In the same place. It was fun just talking about it. I don't know. Yeah.
But, so, seriously, Lego Batman is freaking awesome. I want to say that right now. That game is really good. I played it for 2 hours yesterday. Yeah, 2 hours, 2.5 hours. That game is so fun. Like, holy crap. And there's...
I've never been a fan of Lego games.
Oh my gosh. I used to be a huge fan of the one Lego game I had, but...
I played Star Wars.
Yeah, I played Lego Star Wars, and I liked it. And I don't know, I liked it, and I played it. But that was when I was younger, and I didn't fully understand, like, I don't know. I was
confusing to me.
Yeah, it was confusing.
There are no words being said.
There are lots of puzzle elements to Lego, and by the way, there are words in Lego games, but back then there wasn't. Yeah, but this is like a full-fledged story of the Joker and Batman going, we've got to stop him, Robin. And dude, it's so funny because sometimes they completely like just make fun of DC characters, and then other times they like completely celebrate DC characters. Like Batman is still like a boss, even though he's Lego Batman. But Robin is like scared of everything. He's still fighting and stuff, but like he's in the sewers and he's like, oh, rats, oh, and you like keep hearing him. Like you'll be walking and you'll hear Robin behind you going, oh, it's great, and then you'll switch to him and he'll be like. And, like, each character does things while they're idle. Like, Batman, I don't know why this is cool to me. But, like, Batman, while he's idle, he's like, da-da-da-da, or something like. And then Robin will just start, like, dancing. It's great. Oh my gosh. It's great. But, dude, there are more than 150 characters you can play as in that game.
What?
You can play as everybody. Everybody. Like, that's why I'm so excited.
Everyone at DC, can you play Superman?
Yes, you can play Superboy, Supergirl. You can play as different versions of Superman.
Power Girl.
Probably. I bet you money, dude. Hold on. Lego Batman, three characters. I bet you can. You can play as Nightwing. You can play as the Bronze Tiger. Remember that guy from Arrow? You can play as...
Yeah.
And since I got the season pass, I have the Arrow pack as well. So I'll be playing... Oh, I can be Oliver Queen from Arrow. I could be Diggle. I could be Felicity.
What?
It's really good. I'll stream this sometime to show you. It's a lot of fun.
Oh my gosh, dude.
And you know how you were saying it was very confusing to you when you were a kid? It was to me, too. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I ever even beat that game. But now, since I'm older, like, it all sort of makes sense. Like, the game has a lot of puzzle elements where you have to, like, figure out where to go and what to destroy and what to build.
I remember back in...
But now it's
Star Wars.
Fine. It's really good.
I played the Star Wars one back on PS2, and, something disguises. Like, you would have to use disguises and...
Yeah, there's a suit system. Cyborg, apparently, I haven't gotten to this point yet, but I watched reviews and they pointed this out. Cyborg, when he puts on his stealth suit, he's a washing machine that just hops around.
It doesn't seem that there is Power Girl. Out of all 150 characters,
Metal Gear.
It doesn't seem.
I played Metal Gear Solid 4, and like, you like hide in a box.
Actually,
a box.
I think Power. Yeah, I remember that. I think Power Girl might be DLC. She is.
Oh my gosh.
That's great. That's great. She's there. I'll unlock Power Girl eventually. But yeah, like, I don't know, just the prospect of it. Like, I'm slowly moving in the game. Like, I only have Batman, Robin, Alfred, and you can play as Alfred. And, who else? Martian Manhunter and Green Lantern. So only five right now. Like, and that's like 2 hours. So I'm like slowly chipping away. And I just love the idea that eventually I will have 150 awesome DC characters that like I can just switch in and out. Yeah. And then I can just, and I know about Vibe. Freaking Vibes.
It's going that's awesome. Alone.
I'm like scrolling through right here. Wonder Girl. Let's see. Star Girl. No, that's. Oh, never mind. Shazam. Of course. Like, I'm just, I don't know. It's really, I'm very excited. And from the 2 hours I played, it was just, I don't know, it was really good. There was like one mission that was very puzzly, and then teaching you the basics, and then another was this awesome boss battle, and then another turned into a twin stick shooter in the air, like freaking Rezogun.
That's legit.
It's good. As soon as I get home from youth group and watch The Walking Dead, I'm probably gonna get back.
Oh yeah, Walking Dead.
Yeah, I'm very excited about that. But as soon as I'm getting a phone call. Here, you can talk about one of the topics.
Scroll okay. Through. Go. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Apparently, Rock Band 4 is coming out. I've never been a big fan of Rock Band. I was more of the other game band, Guitar Hero. I love Guitar Hero. But Rock Band 4 is coming to PS4, which is cool.
I'm back. What are you talking about?
We're back. I talked about Rock Band 4 real fast.
Yeah.
I've never been a giant Rock Band fan. I played a lot of Guitar Hero.
I liked it. But I didn't love it. Like
I was good at Guitar Hero.
But anyways,
expert on everything.
Anyways, I know we've already moved on, but I'm OCD and I feel like I need to conclude the last segment. That's what we've been playing. Yes. I'm going to continue playing more Lego Batman throughout the week. It's going to be cool. I'll let you know. We'll let you know about the order next week. And now on to the news. There we go.
Yes, on the news.
Transition. Bam, completed. A little late, but completed. The phone call just messed everything up. So, yeah, Rock Band 4, dude. A lot of people are really, really pumped about that. I put on my Gunners.
GG.
So, yeah, a lot of people are really excited about Rock Band 4. Apparently, all of your DLC and pre-purchased songs can be transferred over. And they are working on a way with PlayStation and with Xbox to hook up your old instruments. Like, you can't at the moment, but they're, like, really talking with them, trying to get it to be a thing. Which is really awesome. So, yeah. Be on the lookout. Rock Band 4, guys. That's I don't know.
What was your favorite Guitar Hero Rock Band game?
Well, Guitar Hero 2 was the first console game I ever owned. So.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So Guitar Hero 2 was the only one I owned, but I played Rock Band like at a bunch of friends. Yeah. Rock Band was awesome. I really liked the drums.
I was introduced to Rock Band 3 on the Wii. That was interesting because the way that it connected to the Wii was you had to put the Wii remote into the guitar, and it connected to the guitar with like
you. That is weird.
And then put it in there and you.
It's cool though.
You put like it's kind of like a battery compartment for the Wii remote.
Yeah.
And so you put it in there, so you can, and it shows up on the front, so you can like press the buttons on the Wii remote.
That was really cool.
Have the guitar. But then after that, my dad got an Xbox 360. When I went over to his house, he had Guitar Hero World Tour. That was my favorite.
Yeah.
Because that's where I learned like Bon Jovi and all that good stuff.
Yeah, I just remember playing Freebird. like a billion times on Guitar Hero 2 on my PlayStation 2.
You remember Slow Ride on Guitar Hero 3?
I didn't own any others after that.
Really?
Okay. No, like, dude, I told you, this is how my console thing started. Somebody gave me a PS2 with a Guitar Hero 2, and a controller and a memory card. And that was the only way my parents would let me get a console. And then I played that for like 6 months. And then I got I got enough money, and I went and bought Star Wars Battlefront 2, and I played that for like a year. And then I asked for a PS3. Like the only PS2 games. Oh, I don't know. I also got Sly Cooper, Thievius Raccoonus at one point. So I owned three PS2 games. Was it just three? And then I moved on to a PS3, got Black Ops, Uncharted 2, and then
rolled over. I started with a Nintendo, Super Nintendo, with Donkey Kong Country and Super Mario World, and those were my two first games. And then after that, I got a PS2. PS2 for like the first years of my life.
I played Super Mario Bros. A billion times because it was all I had, because I had that on a Game Boy Color for like years. But I beat that game like four times, probably more. But yeah, I'm kind of excited for Guitar Hero or Rock Band.
My favorite game on PS2 was Star Wars Starfighter.
I've heard of that.
You played as the yellow ships that I cannot think of.
Star Wars Battlefront though, dude. You know that game was awesome. By the way, we are definitely gonna see more of that for. At E3.
I'm so happy seeing these pictures. I'm like looking it up.
Are you looking up old pictures of
Star Wars Starfighter? Oh my gosh.
Nice.
But yeah, that was great.
Yeah, I got into it late because my parents thought I would be addicted, and to their right, I was. They didn't know the monster that they created. Well, they did know. That's why they were trying to stop from creating it. Like
YOLO,
they said. I don't know, dude. YOLO. I gosh dang it. Dude, I'm going to, you know, college in the next semester, and I'm going in to computer science, and I know I'm not gonna be smart enough to do that, so I'm probably gonna change to audio and video production. That's also a thing. That's my backup. But
you could do that.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd be totally down with that. That'd be fun.
Help you with your
That'd be fun.
YouTube and Twitch stuff, you know?
Yeah, that'd be fun. But I don't think it would help with that, but I think I could take knowledge from YouTube and Twitch stuff into that. That's why I think it wouldn't be bad. But yeah, whatever I do though, like computers, but either of those, like I really want to work in the video game industry. Like I will feel like it was such a waste to, like, play all these games and have, like, honestly, I have such a freaking, like, passion for games that, like, if I don't use it in a job to make money, I'll feel like it's just wasted.
To live up.
Yeah. Because, like, I don't know, dude. I have been, I don't know. I've been, I freaking.
I kind of agree. Because, like, dude, I think the perfect job would be, like, an idea guy. For games, I swear, for me at least.
Gosh dang.
I don't know, an idea.
That's cool, but you're thinking of like a dream world.
Yeah, I know. That's like a dream job there.
I honestly just want to work in something. Like, if I work for somebody making the next PlayStation Move game, I'll realize it's dumb, but I'm technically in the games industry, so I'll be like, all right, there we go. But, anyways, we have a lot of news to talk about. You chose the last one because I was gone. Let's talk about this little thing called the Project Morpheus.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. Freaking, so we've heard about the Project Morpheus for like a year
it's
now.
It's been like
and
tested.
Yeah, we've heard about it for like a year. It's been at conventions and whatnot. But now PlayStation officially announced on a tweet that Project Morpheus will be launching as a consumer product in the first half of 2016. So, actually launching
5 steps ahead of
it's like
the
10
Oculus.
Billion steps ahead of Oculus. Oculus is still like
in development.
We're still conceptualizing it, even though there's like two development kits that are already out. We're still figuring it out. Which to their point, like I feel like Oculus is going to slowly build it into, like, eventually where it's freaking Sword Art Online, you know?
Yeah.
Like, they're taking their time to do it right with, like, I don't know, not just, look, you can see stuff and move around, sort of. Like, I feel like they're actually gonna, like, make a walking stand, like you've seen with the people strapped in. Like, I feel like Oculus is gonna do that, and PlayStation's trying to get ahead of the curve, which, to be fair...
Well, I think PlayStation is focusing on just the virtual...
Yeah, I don't think that I'm going to get it. Ever. Well, maybe someday in, like, millions of years. But, like, I don't think right now that it's good enough
play,
to, like...
If I can play Battlefield and, like, look around, I might get it. That's kind of cool.
See, you won't. For years and years, all you're going to be able to do is go on, like, a roller coaster. Or, like, maybe do small...
Space simulator or something.
You could. You could do Battlefield, but it's not going to be near as good as with a controller. Like, that's the thing. Let me find this.
I know when you're playing on Battlefield 4, you can, like, tilt the controller left and right, and you can, like, lean on Battlefield by tilting the controller.
Yeah, that's nowhere near as the same. Like, you are using all buttons to move, to look around, to aim, to shoot. Imagine that as a VR thing. Can you? Because I can't.
Oh, and wait. If I can, like, aiming?
Yeah, I'm thinking about Battlefield. You said Battlefield as Project Morpheus. That's not going to happen. That's not going to be a thing.
Oh, I don't see why it couldn't.
How are you going to move without a controller?
Your controller.
But see, that's the thing. Why controller? Like, this is VR. This should be VR, virtual reality. You should be in that world. You shouldn't have to worry about a controller. It should be some way to walk. Like,
no, VR has always been.
Yeah, but what are you saying? What you're describing is PlayStation Move, but with a screen on your head, and you can look around.
I'm saying, like that's not Minecraft, and you can look around and do stuff, like look around without having to move your mouse or anything.
See that's always how
VR's been.
Yeah, but that's what they're trying to get away from. They're trying, at least Oculus, Project Morpheus might be perfectly fine with this, but Oculus is trying to make literally you are in a virtual world. Like, you do not have a controller. You put on the headset. Somehow you move. Somehow you do everything. Like, you put on a headset and you're in Sword Art Online, you know?
Okay, well...
Like, that's the future that... I mean, they're probably not aiming for that now. But, like, if I put on the thing and I could look around, like, it was Minecraft and, you know, I could use a controller, I honestly do not care. Like, I'd rather just...
That's how it's been and that's how it's going to be because you always have peripheral... in your hands.
But see, there shouldn't be.
Around,
the future of VR, mate.
Looking around is just making it immersified and in your face.
I know.
That's all it does.
You can... But I'm saying the future of VR, the one that I care about, is where you don't need a peripheral. You don't need a controller. Somehow...
It's not going to happen.
It can. It is very possible. Have you seen those things? You said it yourself. You've seen those things where the dudes are walking around. They have the guns.
Yes, like, they have a peripheral.
It's a thing. Gun is sort of a peripheral. I don't want to move with a controller. Otherwise, I can just sit in front of a screen and, like, use a controller.
I've seen one for Battlefield where they had, like, Oculus, and he had a gun of some sort, and he had this whole plate that he would walk around.
Yeah, see, that's all right. That I'm okay with as VR. Like, that I would probably buy and use. That's pretty futuristic and kind of cool.
In your hand.
But what I'm saying is, like,
sit there with an Oculus on your head and, okay, shoot that guy. Okay, shoot that guy. I don't know what he's looking for.
I thought my PlayStation Move controllers were in there, but they're not. Basically, what I imagine what you're saying is this...
Yeah.
Like, using this to, like, move. Just...
Yeah.
That's PlayStation Move, but with a screen on your head. That's not anything I'm interested in.
I watch a lot of YouTubers, and when they use the Oculus, they have a controller. They usually don't use mouse and keyboard.
Yeah.
Because mouse and keyboard, there's a lot of buttons and stuff.
Yeah.
But with a controller, all the buttons are right here in your hand.
But, I kind of understand, but like, unless it's, I don't know. I'm really not interested in VR until way, way, way in the future. Like, that just honestly sounds like, well, like I said, it sounds like PlayStation Move.
To diversify you into the game, and it takes the screen and puts it right in your face like you're in the game.
I don't know. I guess I can see doing that, because, I mean,
you get... I see what you're saying, though. You're trying, like, you're saying, like, remove the peripheral. I want like, to experience it with just sight or something.
Yeah, because, I don't know. I have never... When I think of VR... You know. When I think of VR, I do not think of PlayStation Move, and that's what it is, apparently. And, like...
Well, okay, there's games that use the Razer Hydras. They're like, it's pretty much like PlayStation Move or the Wii remotes or something, but it's like for PC, and but they also have it to where it connects for the Oculus, and it all works together.
Yeah, I mean, again, I understand this. I just don't really have an
interest. They also have like a head mount. Also on the development too, the second development of the Oculus has head tracking. Usually. If you moved your head this way or this way, it would just lean you or something. But now, if you move your head down here, it tells the game that your head is down here now. It moves you
down.
Yeah,
so, I mean, I guess it makes sense, because like when you're playing a game with a normal controller and like a normal monitor, like you still get lost in the game and you forget about your controller. Like The game is really immersive when you forget you're using a controller and you're just going. Like, I assume that's what they're going for. And I think you can do that with a controller.
I think if you are able to try the Oculus or the Morpheus.
Yeah, I feel like I'll...
You will see, like, the connection with... It will probably flow.
I
mean,
I understand it. I'm just saying, like... Like, even now, understanding this, I don't care about... Like, I'm not going to get the Project Morpheus.
I'm not going to get Project Morpheus.
I'm not really interested in... Like I said, I still stand by this. I'm not interested in VR until way in the future where it's super advanced. Because right now, I
riding roller coasters.
I have a monitor. Work. I don't know. Like, I understand it's a... I feel like it's kind of like with... It's not on the same level of gimmicky, but I feel at the moment it's a tiny bit like it increases your experience by like 5%. You know, it just gets a little bit cooler, kind of like with the 3D on a 3DS, you know, stuff like that. Right. Like it just gets a little bit cooler. I'm like, okay, but I have a monitor. Like that's what it feels like for now. But then again, I've never tried it. Then again, I do want to try it. I just don't feel like it'll take over. It's not going to take over gaming for
big difference years. Is that the only big difference with VR is that your vision is in the game. Instead, you don't see your computer and your mouse and all this stuff. But you see the game and the game itself. And also, when you look around, you can see to your... Like, if you're playing Battlefield, you look to the left, you can see your teammates over here to your left.
Yeah, but what happens when you want to turn all the way around? You turn all the way around.
Oh, you can turn all the way around.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Like, who wants... This is like a Wii problem. Who wants to stand in front of a TV? This is like why I stopped...
One of the reasons why I stopped playing Skyward Sword. You don't have to. You can mouse and turn around.
Well, that's the point. That's normal games. That's normal games. You can move the mouse and turn around.
Yeah, but if you want to have your gun here, you can still look to your left if you want to. Or you can... Stand up and look above your gun or something like that. I don't know.
I'm just saying it sort of gets to the point where it was with Move and where it was with Wii and stuff, where like you're there playing a game and like imagine you're doing all sorts of stuff. Like, I don't know.
Wait, chivalry.
most people just want to, at least now, I bet Project Morpheus will eventually change my opinion on this. Like, eventually it'll all change and stuff. I mean, and
if you think about it,
oh my gosh,
Morpheus is just like the same thing as Oculus. Then Anyway. We gotta have to have something to improve on.
But yeah, it'll change. My opinion will change because the products will get better and developers mm-hmm. will make stuff for the products. But it's like right now, it seems the current version of VR seems like a little bit like Move and Wii, where you're going to be standing and stuff, and it's like
I honestly prefer a
controller. But like the future of VR, I'm interested in. Well. Now you're just current VR, not really interested in. Sort of, kind of future VR interested.
It's restoring VR. We should talk about Valve's.
Oh yeah, nice segue, mate. Mm-hmm. Valve is also making a VR headset.
Yeah,
that's pretty much it. It's developed. I want
a VR headset that has headphones built in. Like, yeah. Can we get that?
Yeah, dude. That's
because you know you see the straps on it.
Yeah,
it's like covering the ear area, kind of. Yeah, why isn't there? Actually, that would go over the ears, but anyways, still.
Take a look at this, people. This is.
I think it looks pretty cool. I think they can do a good job, and I see it has motion tracking by the front of it.
It's made by HTC. They used to make a bunch of phones, is all I know. They probably still do. It's called the Vive, which is not a bad name.
The Vive.
It's interesting. it's definitely an interesting name. Let's see. It's a 90 FPS device. 360 degrees viewing, of course. It's just another VR thing.
Like, I don't know. We'll have to see what people...
Like, I don't know. I
want to see some of the software for these things, too. So
yeah, I just want to reiterate my point that I'm sort of kind of interested in current VR. But future VR, I'm very interested in. But current stuff is just sort of like... I'm not jumping up and down going, oh, man, Oculus or the Morpheus is going to be the next big thing. It's not. Like, that's what I'm saying. Morpheus is not going to take over gaming. And
I was wrong. Not all games use peripherals. The game that I saw someone play, when you looked at the thing and you looked away and looked back at it, it was completely different, and that's how you progressed during the game. You would look at it, and then this, and then...
Yeah, that seems just like a demo.
It is a tech demo. It was really cool.
But, yeah. Like, I'm just saying that I don't think VR is... Like, I don't think Morpheus is going to come out next year, and we're all going to be like, oh, yeah, we're dropping all our controllers. We're just playing with Morpheus, man. This is the future of gaming. Like, it is. But, like, right now, I'm not going to... I don't think it's going to be huge. Yet. I think eventually it will get to the point. Maybe. But right... I don't know. You can't go wrong with the DualShock 4. Like, there's nothing wrong with this bad boy. It's so good. It's so good. Everything fits together.
I mean, of course, when you see them at the expos and cons and stuff, the Morpheus, they're using DS4s.
Yeah, I'm just... Yeah. I just don't... I don't know. Like I said, right now it just seems like a tiny bit of a Wii syndrome.
I still think I haven't even tried it.
Looks interesting.
And neither of you, but I think if we tried it, we would have a different opinion on it as well.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know. Again, I'm waiting for the day where
I really like games that a lot of horror games are. The main aspect of horror games is to immerse you, and its atmosphere.
Yeah, well, that's good for that.
It's good for that.
Yeah.
I don't know. Because you can't just shield your eyes.
That is true. You can't just be like, oh, I don't want to look. It's on your head.
You can look away.
It's stuck for there. Yeah, you could, I guess. But then it's going to get to you eventually.
Yeah, that's true.
There are lots of things
just
still
imagine
here.
That, like, you're playing a horror game, it's really dark, and you can hear something around the corner, so you just, like, peep your head out. That's freaky, so, I mean,
yeah.
It immerses you. But anyway, we should probably move on to something else.
All right, let's see. Wolfenstein, the people who made Wolfenstein announced before Wolfenstein, The New Order, there was The Old Blood. They're making a standalone DLC called Wolfenstein The Old Blood.
Oh. prequel.
Yeah, it's a prequel to what happened in the original Wolfenstein. I assume it'll be like $20 or something. Yeah, it's $20.
Yeah.
May 5th. Yeah, if you enjoyed the original Wolfenstein, I'm sure it'll
heard
be
everything
good
about it.
Yeah.
The only thing bad about it is I've heard it's really shoot 'em up type-esque, but I mean, people like that.
Yeah, that's not a bad thing.
Not a bad thing, yeah.
No.
It's just a different style.
Let's cover all the minor things, and then I have a couple big things I want to take a look at. So, I hate to call this a minor thing, but I don't know. Harrison Ford... I mean,
entertainment, that's not really...
Yeah, Harrison Ford, mate, was...
Yeah.
Injured in a plane crash that he was piloting. Mm-hmm. I don't fully know much about it. I just know that.
I looked at a bunch about it. He was flying and something I'm not sure what happened, but he was over a city of some sort and something happened to his ship and he safely landed in a golf course.
Yeah, all right then. Yeah, he's injured, but I just thought it would note it because it was a little scary when I heard it. I was like,
what's his face just died? Spock?
Yeah, Leonard Nimoy died as well, so that not as well. Harrison Ford did not die. But
yeah.
So I was a little scared, but then I looked into it, and he was just seriously
injured. Yeah, his son said that his dad's doing okay.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, good. All good.
So, NVIDIA is launching a console an Android-based console. Because that goes so well every time it's been tried.
Well, apparently...
Remember the Ouya?
I've actually read a lot about this, and, like... It's the one that, like, streams games in 60 FPS and all that.
Yeah, it does that as well.
It's like a tiny, thin... It's about big as this little thing right here.
Yeah.
You know, it's, like, this big. It literally just streams stuff. It doesn't actually play the game. It streams it from a PC.
Is this for real?
Yeah, it's like you're playing a PC, but you can... It's, like, this big. And has all the ports you need, has gigabyte internet and everything.
But
it streams from your PC to your NVIDIA thing, the NVIDIA console. And then it goes onto your TV in 60 FPS and 1080p.
It says the NVIDIA Shield can run both local and streamed games via its NVIDIA Grid subscription-based game streaming service. So, yeah. Actually, I didn't read much about this. This sounds cool, to be totally honest. If you're going to do an Android-based console, this is the way to go. Have some sort of PlayStation Now-type service with games. This looks cool, dude.
It's a good... Like, you could poke it up to your TV over there and play your PC games.
I don't know. This is a cool idea. Hopefully they have better streaming than PlayStation Now. PlayStation Now isn't bad, but hopefully they just have it.
Now is getting better.
Yeah, I hope. Wait, did you hear that the streaming was getting better, or like the games?
Yeah, they said it was like update 2. Something. Wait, what update is PlayStation right now?
2.04, I think.
Okay, on 2.05, they're apparently making streaming better. For PlayStation Now.
Awesome. I might have to do that because I have Infamous 2 and I can just jump back in with my cloud saves and I can just go in and try and platinum it. Oh, man. Now, it's too expensive, though. That's the problem. PlayStation Now is $20 a month. I can't do it. I just can't. Okay. Speaking of PlayStation updates, we have an article here about future PlayStation updates. So yeah, that was a pretty awesome segue, if I do say so myself. Left
directional button jump now.
Dude, holy crap. So seriously, I was gonna save this to last, but whatever. This freaking holy balls. Like there's pictures of like the software update that might be coming to PlayStation. And
can we use a keyboard and mouse now?
Look at this. Customized button assignments. Like, what? This is a thing that people have been wanting since the beginning of consoles. Since the beginning of time, we have wanted this. Like, people always, like, I've seen threads from people that are, like, disabled, that are like, I can't use these buttons, but I can use these buttons. Developers, why can't we remap our buttons? This is in the software. You wouldn't even need the developers. This would be for every game. My only thing is, like, it would be, I wish I could program these for specific games, though. Like, if so, then it's perfect. Like, if I can program in Call of Duty, because they don't have a bumper jumper, X is L1 and L1 is X, and I can, like, switch the two, but only for Call of Duty.
Dude, I feel like I would like bumper jumper if bumper jumper was R1.
Oh, man. See, I was a little weirded out by Dying Light because it was R1 and not L1.
I like R1.
It's not that bad, dude. You just, next game you get, you need to just turn it on immediately, and then it's fine. Like, it's great. I much prefer it. But, yeah, seriously, that would be the best thing ever if you could do that. Like, holy crap. Just holy crap. That's it. So, Melissa Benoist as the new, I don't know how to say her last name. I'm guessing that's how to say her last name. As the new Supergirl in the show produced by one of the producers who produces Arrow and Flash. So it'll be in that universe, probably. They released a picture of her in costume. So look at that. Dude, what do you think of this costume?
What? Let me see it.
Because, I mean, it's not a bad costume, but, like,
I think it's the background of this photo. I don't like the background on this photo.
I
should have done it in a brighter background so I can actually see it.
It looks a tiny bit low budget.
Gold.
It looks a tiny bit low budget. Like,
it does kind of.
Like, the boots look like, I don't know, the whole thing looks like, so far they've done a good job of making the costumes look real and not like, maybe it's just a picture, but like, her costume looks like a toy. Like,
I don't know. Like, well, I mean, it looks more professional than a toy, like a costume. But I mean, like, you've got.
But see,
like,
to me, it doesn't. It doesn't look like a costume. It looks like the boots are, like, shiny, like on a Barbie doll boots. I don't know. But
I can't even tell. The picture's so dark.
You have a big problem with this background and where this picture was taken.
Okay, literally,
you're offended by this.
And how then little white.
How dare they?
I can't even see the back of the cape or anything. I don't know. But anyway.
Dude, look at the. I'm trying to find the first picture of that was shown of the Flash. It was in the same background, yeah. The first look at the full costume was him in, like, bent over. You couldn't even see the full thing.
Yeah, I didn't like that picture either. I hated it. Because it looked weird.
I think it looks great. Oh well, you just have a problem with these pictures.
I don't.
These pictures are coming to get you.
People don't know how to take pictures.
But they do. It's the art. It's the style of the show. Is that it's gonna?
Okay, that's fine. Like, but take better pictures. Better lighting.
They did it on purpose. It's not that.
I understand it's on purpose. It's supposed to be dark and serious. Yeah. And all that, but it's not working out for me because I want to see the costume. I want to see what it looks like.
Oh, I can see
lighting it. Everywhere, floodlights everywhere,
blue lights everywhere,
spotlight in the back and the front.
Oh my gosh! Just, and the Sun actual glare. Actor Sun is like, and, oh my goodness! And the actual actor is just like squinting, like, I can't see. Hurry and take the picture. Eyes like watering.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, that's what Eric wants in
blinding
dear,
photos.
Dear Greg Berlanti and Andrew Kreisberg or something, take pictures with blinding light. There you go. Yeah. And Eric will be happy. Let's discuss a couple more things and then we can get out of here. Overwatch Just want to say this. They've been showing stuff from PAX. That game is going to be huge. Like, I don't think people understand.
You know,
this is an FPS competitive shooter by Blizzard. The only thing that could make this game bigger was if it was cross-platform.
Like, yeah.
That was... this game's going to be huge.
I saw someone say something like, I don't like how a lot of games these days are, like, trying to get into esports.
But it's Blizzard. All they do is trying to. Actually, I'm not even sure. They made Hearthstone. They probably weren't trying with Hearthstone.
Yeah, and now there's, like, giant streams about it.
I don't know. But, I like this because, to be honest, the biggest competitive esport games aren't shooters or aren't even action things like MOBAs and MOBAs. So, like, the abilities on these characters and whatnot are like it's a MOBA, but it's a shooter. Like, that's one of the biggest thing that's going to
be. Of course, you can't go without saying that the game kind of reminds you of freaking Team Fortress, only
it
with
does, but
more characters, more abilities, and I think a lot more. I think a lot more like a movement.
To be honest, the mechanics just look better.
That game is so old, so I mean.
Yeah, I don't know. It does, but it doesn't. I don't know. It doesn't warrant being said. Like, all the time about it. Like, most people are always like, oh, this is Team Fortress 2. I'm like...
I think that's a good thing.
It looks like it's very much... It's very much its own thing, you know?
Well, yeah.
Sign up for the beta. There you go. Look at... Yeah. Go to us.battle.net/Overwatch/EN. They have good links, by the way. Freaking Blizzard, dude. They're the best. And then scroll down. There's a beta sign up. So, yeah. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. There are 14 characters at the moment, and there are 4 different roles that characters can have. Like, it's freaking MOBA, by the way.
Yeah, I'm sure you have, like,
there's, DPS like, tanks, support. Defense, support, assault, crap. Oh, dude. This game
is... It kind of reminds me of, like, Evolve, when you're playing, like...
Yeah, like, if this... The only thing that can make this game better for me was if it was on PS4. So
I don't know. I can agree if it was like on PS4, but since it's on PC, it's gonna have. I think they might have the maps and the gameplay designed for mouse and keyboard.
Yeah.
Because like say maybe you can't have the same reaction time to use a certain ability.
I don't know. I just don't like... I mean, I'll play it. I just wish... I would rather play games on PS4, so that's why I'm just saying that. Like, I would just rather...
I don't know. I didn't go to my PC. I want something on my PC. And this looks like something...
I mean, to be honest, I really don't... Like, I don't have an urge to go back and play anything on PC, but, like, because of that game, I will. You're like, I like my PC. I miss my PC. I want to play some more things on there. And I'm like,
I can't just neglect my PC because I've wanted it so much. And I finally got it.
Yeah.
And I can do the things I want. So, I mean, you had your PC for a long time. And I mean,
yeah, I guess.
I still love my PS4.
I guess. I just don't. I don't know. I don't.
But I mean, I don't. If you guys weren't getting Dying Light, I would have gotten it on PC.
Yeah, I wouldn't have. See, I don't know. Like if it's between I've said this many times. I just like playing games in the PlayStation ecosystem.
If Bloodborne was on PC, I would get it on PC.
I would absolutely not in a million years. Like, I just like playing games more with a DualShock and with trophies. Like,
You just care about trophies. That's all you care about.
Both.
So.
I care about playing games. I like playing on my PlayStation. I like looking on my friends list and seeing what other people are playing. I like using my DualShock 4. I like getting my trophies. That's 3 reasons right there.
This stage is called denial.
Oh, no. I'm not in denial. I love trophies. I very much am a little bit obsessed with trophies. But, like... I just named off 3 reasons. I like being on my PS4. I like I play on my Vita too. I like freaking, and I like that they're connected. Like, I like being able to look on my friends list on my Vita. If somebody sends me a message from PS4, I get it on my Vita.
If Microsoft had this, this whole getup, if you could connect, if they had a mobile platform like the Vita, and if they had a console and their operating system on PC, if they all like conjoined in like one thing, that'd be beautiful. But unfortunately, Sony doesn't have an operating system or like a lineup of
that, or really
their own thing. You know what I'm saying?
Sort of, yeah.
I'm saying, what if you could
get
like
the
stream...
Windows 10 thing? But I don't care.
Okay, no. I'm saying, like, what if you could stream Persona 4 onto your PC?
I and play can that? With that a PlayStation TV. Awesome. It's on my monitor. I don't need it to be
on my PC. Oh, no, I meant,
PC.
Like, your PC.
Yeah, but why? I don't need it on my PC.
You have a list of all your games, like, on your PC.
But why? I have that on my PlayStation library.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying, you know? Like, they're very much options. Their own things.
Options. Like, I'm saying you have options.
Yeah, but I already have so many options. That's the thing. Like, each...
I'm just saying, what if?
Yeah. Well, yeah. Each different thing is very, like, each platform is very much its own ecosystem. Mm-hmm. Like, people that play games that on Xbox, a lot of the time, there are people that have Xbox Ones and then they have PCs. And, like, if they're, like, Dying Light is a PC and Xbox One game, like, they will most likely get it on Xbox One, just like me with PS4. They just prefer that ecosystem. Like I said, I have friends on my PS4 friends list that I only have on my friends list, and then I just sometimes send messages to and talk to on the PlayStation. I like the system over there. Yeah, I got the free PS Plus.
When you send a message on PSN and it says you sent that like 60 minutes ago.
My PS, but that's only me, dude. I don't know what's up with that because yours works fine. Oh, okay.
No, it happens to me too. Okay. Like it takes like 3 minutes to send a message.
Sometimes it's fine though. That's what's dumb.
Yeah, exactly.
Sometimes it's great. And then other times it takes like 10 minutes.
20 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Like, I just sent it. It's not.
I definitely ain't saying it's not flawed. Yeah. It's very much flawed.
PSN.
Yeah, I do wish the messaging worked better. The messaging needs to work better. And I like the party system. The only thing I want from the party system is being able to change somebody to leader or boot them out of the thing. That's it. That'd be cool.
You cannot kick people.
You can't.
That's like a staple in Xbox.
Yeah, I know. That's like, why it's
this
crazy.
Not annoying. Bang.
Yeah, that's why it's crazy. Like, people have had this feature for years and it's not there. With being able to change your PSN name, that's been a thing on Xbox forever.
Yeah, you
Steam
have to pay like
and Minecraft, but it's just not a thing on PlayStation. And every time people address it, they're like, "We might work on it." Like, why is it not already there? I don't know. But other than the negative, I don't know, dude. Like, I just like it there. It's fun. It's where I prefer to play games. Okay. So, your boy Ryan Clements, the PlayStation powerhouse over at PlayStation Blog, has posted the drop. I thought we'd go over it like we were planning on doing every week, but I forgot to do it last week.
It's your link.
Yeah. Well, go to the PlayStation Blog. It's the first thing there. But while you do that, there is one other topic that I want to cover real quick. I was going to show people that PlayStation, you may have seen on your PlayStation store over at your over in your hometown, maybe in Chicago, maybe in Illinois. I don't know where you live. There is a sale called the Spring Fever Sale. And basically what they're doing is every week... for up until like April 21st or something, like every week they are releasing like a really good game, and it's like releasing 10% off like every week. Like Helldivers released this week, next week it'll be Hotline Miami 2 or this upcoming Tuesday, which is gonna be a really good game, and then the week I thought I'd just go over, so now you know what it is if you were a little confused about what that was about. Where the heck is my... Oh! You're in the tab. Never mind. So yeah. Here's a look at this. Jamestown the week after that, Metal Slug 3, Axiom Verge, Bastion, Titan Souls, and last but freaking not least, Shovel Knight. I am very excited for Shovel Knight. Shovel Knight's like April 21st, I think. I might be wrong about that. But
I'm looking at the drop stuff.
Yeah. But Shovel Knight.
The biggest thing there is Devil May Cry.
Yeah. We will go over the drop. You can give us... Oh, no! Oh, no, dude. We didn't get time to talk about the 100 or Walking Dead.
Oh, we can fit that in.
Well, let's do that real quick. We'll end with the drop, and then we'll go. But I have, like, probably, like, 5 minutes. So...
Okay.
The 100. Yeah, the 100.
Lex is a poop hole.
Dude, me and Eric were watching that together because there was no Arrow that we normally watch together. So
we watched that at, like... 1 o'clock at night.
I was so upset for like 3 days, dude. Like seriously, 2 days after that, I was like, I still didn't know what to do with my freaking life. I was so confused. Dude,
freaking Clark is gonna go on a massacre, I think.
Oh, dude.
She's gonna kill Lexa.
Yeah. So basically, spoilers. They were setting this up as this huge, they had set up this alliance all season, and they set it up, and it was going to be this huge Return of the King epic battle, and the door was opening, the whole army was about to flood in, and Lexa walks up and was like, oh, I just made a deal with the guy, our people are safe, your people are still in there. It was
like a scary battle for like 3 minutes, just like, why would you do that? What would you do that?
That steering battle was warranted because I was doing that. Yeah. I was like, why would you do that? Why would you?
All those people. What? You kissed me.
Oh my gosh. I wish I could make GIFs. I would totally make a GIF of what you just did. You were like. But, yeah.
Dude, like, Clark was like freaking out. Like,
I was freaking out.
Someone would do this. Why would someone do this?
I still can't. I told Eric that was the most shocking thing that I've seen on
television. And Lexa doesn't even quote this. She's like, that's what you would have done.
Yeah, right. Clark would not have done that. I'm going to say that right now. I don't think Clark would have done that. Like, she made a promise. Like, that was a treaty. She was going to honor that. I don't know.
And now we're going to go back to murdering grounders.
Yeah, I know, right? It's freaking... Kill Lexa in her face, right?
Face.
Sorry. I got really violent on Twitter when that happened. I like tweeted like 5 times about how horrible Lexa was and how I was so confused because like I still can't believe it. I'm reopening old wounds now.
All right, Walking Dead.
Oh yeah, Walking Dead.
I feel like they were settling down.
It was really good. Just want to say that. Walking Dead was really good. Really good.
Rick, he's like all...
Yeah, Rick doesn't have his beard no more. He didn't have. Yeah, he don't have his beard no more. His beard's
clean,
gone.
Clean shaven.
Was awesome, by the way. Wasn't it super cool to see him without the beard? Like, he was, like, a completely different person. Like, when that happened, I was watching, I was just like...
So, season one.
What? That's so cool. Just because it's like, oh, dude. I don't know.
But I think what's going to happen is, like, I think they've gotten to the point where we don't have to worry about the inside. We worry about what's coming on from the outside. I think...
I kind of agree.
It was during the night and was like looking at Rick that he was like, "Oh, hey. You know my wife, blah blah blah." Hey.
Yeah, dude, that was funny. That was dumb. I was like, "What? Why did he just?" Yeah, he's like, "Hey, my wife cut your hair."
Welcome to Alexandria.
That was it. Basically, somebody posted a picture of that, and they were like, basically, the guy was just saying, "Hey, you, that was my wife. F you, mate." Like, that was all he was saying. Because that's what it sounded like. But,
Welcome to Alexandria. It's really menacing.
Yeah. But seriously, what the freak? The ending was so awesome. Like, I don't think they're gonna... Okay. Basically, everything was fine. what was weird was that normally when something good happens or when something good is about to happen, I'm like, oh man, you know, oh, this isn't going to be good. Something's going to happen. But the whole episode was like, they actually got to enjoy stuff for like a second. But, so yeah, I don't fully trust these people, but I trust them a little bit. But what was crazy,
I trust the congresswoman.
At the end of the episode, Rick and all of his people, Rick and Carol and Daryl were standing, Carol and Daryl, I never realized that rhymed. They were standing outside, and they were, Carol said something about, like, this place will make us weak, and that's what, yeah. That's what Carl said, too, and, Rick's just like, I thought about that, but if these people get, or something, and then,
we can take it over.
Yeah, they were like, he goes, if,
these people don't survive.
Yeah, yeah, if these people don't survive, or if we, if they try something, we'll just take it.
Yeah.
And then that was it. And I was like, dang. And, but before it said that, it cut back to him talking to the congresswoman in the interview thing where he was like, people are only out there for survival. They'll come in and they'll look for every angle they can get at you. And I'll, and then it cuts back to that and it says that. And I was like, dang, Rick's the bad guy now. Oh, snap. So, yeah. I think the season might go there because me and Andrew were talking about, like, where could this season go? They've already done cannibalism. They've done like everything. So, like, what's left? So, and then what's left is that Rick turns to a bad guy. That's what's left. I don't want it to happen, but it might happen.
You're addicted to survival.
But yeah, I'm the rest of the season is gonna be really good. Like, that last episode was awesome. I'm really excited. I'm very excited for tonight. It's gonna be good.
Yeah.
So the drop. We'll end on this and then I'll leave because it is very close to time that I have to leave. Alter Echo, which is a PS2 classic. Atelier Shally, Alchemist of the Dusk Sea.
What?
It's a PS3 Japanese-looking game. Battle Hunter for PS1 Classic. Devil May Cry Definitive Edition for PS4. It is the most recent reboot for Devil May Cry. A lot of people didn't like that game. I never finished it, but I thought it was alright. I don't know. But Flame Over for PS Vita, which is... That actually doesn't look bad. Blending top-down squirt-em-up action with roguelike RPG mechanics. That doesn't look bad at all. Hotline Miami 2. That game's awesome if you're into torture and horrible freaking just getting your face wrecked in multiple times. Check that out. But seriously, it has a really good soundtrack. It's good. Oh my gosh. Scram Kitty for PS4 and Vita, which is cross-buy. That doesn't look bad either. Sniper Elite 3. Ultimate Edition for PS4 and PS3.
Game.
Sparkle 2 for PS3. And Tokyo Twilight Ghost Hunters. So be on the lookout for Sniper Elite 3, Hotline Miami 2, Devil May Cry, some of the other cool indie stuff like the Squirt 'em Up or the Scram Kitty. They look cool. So, this has been episode 15. I wish we could freaking go 2 hours if we ever wanted to, easily. Like, we could have gone forever on that crap, but yeah, you got something random because I actually have something random. And you don't today.
Yeah, we can show both our random things. I think. Oh my gosh, I feel like I've shown this already.
Oh snap! This might be the first alien repeat. I don't think you'd have.
Okay, good. This is the Alien anthology, all four movies in one amazing series from like the 80s and.
Yeah, you 80s. Have not shown that. I thought you were going to show, like, because you've shown, like, a root beer before, so I thought you were going to show that, and I was like...
Oh, yeah, I have my root beer over here.
Yeah, but,
Well, not the last one was glass, so...
Oh, yeah, that's true. It's true. I have,
That was IBC root beer. This is AW. Yeah.
Cocoa butter lotion.
Oh, dang.
Dude, seriously? Hydrated. Dude, my hands got so cracked and dry the other day that, like, it started bleeding on one of my fingers. Like, on, like, here, on the top of my hand, got really dry. Like, right there. Just started bleeding. And I'm like,
yeah.
Okay. So I started using lotion. Anyways, yeah. There you go. Lotion and movies.
Yep.
So join us next week when we talk about probably elephants, maybe some foxes, because Eric's fox today.
Hopefully we'll have something. I want to see something new about Destiny's future.
Yeah, maybe we'll see something in their update. What? We probably will. So be on the lookout for that. So do your dailies, play some more video games.
Have fun.
Be Superboy in Lego Batman or wherever, somewhere. Be Superboy somewhere. I don't know.
Be scared of rats.
Yeah. Be Robin.
Like Robin.
He's pretty cool. He's a pretty cool dude.